Cholesterol is a fatty substance or lipid that we need as a raw material for making important things we require to keep our bodies healthy. Most of the cholesterol we need, actually we make ourselves, about 80% or more. And that then has to be distributed to where it's needed around the body through the bloodstream. Most people will not have had a cholesterol test, and they will only have been invited to have one with their GP when they show up for an MOT as part of a national health check at the age of 40. But for families where there's early heart disease or known high cholesterol in other family members, they shouldn't wait till they're 40 years of age. High cholesterol is no symptom, so we really have no way of knowing if we have a high cholesterol, except through a blood test. The full lipid profile that's measured on a blood test from your doctor's surgery includes both measurement of the good cholesterol and the bad cholesterol fractions. The bad cholesterol, known as the LDL, is the only cholesterol that can get deposited on the blood vessel linings and therefore can cause narrowing and damage to the arteries. It's the bad cholesterol levels which seem to be most prone to change with age, and it rises steadily through adulthood, and it may rise by as much as 50% or a half between the age of 20 and 50. The cause of the high cholesterol is actually a gene alteration that's not their fault. It's one that actually may explain why so many family members have had an early heart attack or stroke. It's not to do with a bad diet or lifestyle in most cases, but it's something that they couldn't have known about, their family couldn't have known about, and there didn't used to be effective diagnosis and treatment.
Not everybody with an unhealthy diet and lifestyle will have high cholesterol. A lot depends on your genetic makeup, what you inherit from your family. And it's that combination of being predisposed to high cholesterol and also having an unhealthy diet or lifestyle that will mean that you actually end up having raised blood cholesterol. Exercise can lower your cholesterol levels, but it's very much more about overall cardiovascular health. In terms of cholesterol, it's about helping to increase the level of good cholesterol, we call that HDL cholesterol, and helping to lower the level of LDL cholesterol, which we call bad cholesterol.
If the diagnosis of FH is made and the treatment started early, ideally before 18 years of age, it's possible to completely stop the buildup of cholesterol deposits in the arteries. This is what we'd like to achieve in everybody who's affected, but we can only do this if we actually manage to find people and get them started on their healthy diet and lifestyle, along with treatment if needed. There's nothing to be scared of. Just get the test. If you've got the problem, you get it sorted. You might need your treatment adjusted every few years as you get the age-related rise in cholesterol. But, you know, other than that, you know, piece of cake. And much better than, you know, getting to first name terms with cardiologists here in our wonderful institution.